is this old song. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Where am I? Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. with laser precision. Verse number 24. 1 Samuel 7. The New Living Translation gives us the following. As soon as the Israelite army saw him, they began to run away in fright. Repeat these words after me. As soon as the Israelite army saw him, they began to run away in fright. I want you to put a smile on your face right now. I want you to muster the biggest grin you can. And I want you to look at your neighbor with a sanctified grin and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, don't be afraid. Look across the room at somebody and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, I didn't come to bother you. Didn't come to stir your Kool-Aid. But please, don't be afraid. Wonderful God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the preaching and teaching of your word. And as we prepare now, Lord, we ask that your spirit will guide us as your word goes forth in power and authority to accomplish that for which it was sent. Wonderful God, I want to thank you right now for the greater one who lives within us. In your name, God, we pray that the Holy Ghost, who is the convictor, convincer, and persuader of truth, will reveal the truth about the power and integrity of your word to every listener. And God, we pray right now that your word would be helpful to our bodies, strength to our hearts, renewal to our minds. We give you thanks, we give you honor, we give you praise. In Jesus' name, and all of God's folks said, amen. God bless you, ushers. You may be seated. Don't be afraid. Dale Carnegie, Mrs. Hubbard, said, when you're afraid, keep your mind on what you have to do. Mrs. Ramey, and if you have been thoroughly prepared, you will not be afraid. Fear is defined, Sister Walker, as a distressing emotion aroused by impending danger, evil, and pain. Whether the intent is real or imagined, it is the feeling or condition of being afraid. Therefore, fear is an emotion aroused, Ms. Gale, by the thought of impending danger, evil, or pain. Assuming this is correct, it would cause one to begin to think about those things in one's life that would cause them harm. And subsequently, a growing emotion takes over that cripples their movement, cripples their capacity, or the trend to think clearly. I ask my waiting congregation, has your movements ever crippled you by fear? What's going on with you this morning? What's going on in your life right now? What's going on that you are afraid of? Has anyone ever heard of stage fright? Stage fright or performance anxiety, fear or persistent phobia, Dr. Amica, which may be aroused in an individual by the requirement to perform in front of an audience, whether actually or potentially. For some of us, every time we think about an enemy rising up in our lives, we get scared. We get scared to live, scared to move, scared of trying, and even scared of being. My Bible teaches me, Acca, in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, Sister Williams, for God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline. And Sister Williams, I throw it in, early this morning to take a stand against fear. Look at your neighbor right now. Say, neighbor, I'm ready to take my stand against fear. Beloved, I decree and declare right now in Jesus' name that I'm going to take a stand against the enemy. I'm going to take a stand against the Goliaths of my life. I'm going to take a stand, Brother Hubbard, against the sickness that I have allowed to control my life. I'm going to take a stand against any financial debt that has been controlling our lives. I'm going to take a stand against any bullying, be it spiritual or carnal, that would attempt to run the people of God away from their destiny. I want you to look at your neighbor right now and tell your neighbor, don't be afraid. Our unit, our selected portion of the sacred text for examination is housed in the book of 1 Samuel. Scholars hold that the two books of Samuel were originally one book in Hebrew. They were divided in Greek and lacked manuscripts because of the length of the book. Birth, as in the week before last, describes the book of Samuel as what? Drama, drama, and more drama. The book of Samuel gives us the advent and embryonic evolution of the Israelite kingship, the anointing of two of Israel's most prominent king, and a host of remarkable events that helped to define what we have come to know as Israelite culture. This is the text, Brother Augustus Abuka, our text indication that the battle lines had been drawn. But, Abuka, no punches had been thrown. Our text indicates that David, who had been in the pasture shepherding his father's sheep, was sent to the front lines of the battle as directed by his father to check on the status, Ms. Gale, of his brothers. The text indicates, Sister Harmon, that when David arrived, he heard Goliath talking trash to God about God and Israel. The text further indicates that Saul was scared. Jonathan, Saul's son, was scared. The whole army was scared. David's brothers were scared. Everybody was too scared to fight. Text further indicates that Saul had put out a proposal, Brother Roosevelt, that if any man were to kill Goliath, that Saul would make that man wealthy, give that man his daughter's hand in marriage, and take care of that man's family indefinitely. The text indicates, Dr. Amica, that David wanted to know, was there anybody in the camp that wasn't afraid to take a stand against the bullying of a Philistine champion? Please, beloved, come and sit with me just for a few minutes as we expose prophetic truths that I see lodged in the text. Are y'all ready to get on the train? First of all, the text teaches a believer, now, don't be afraid of your bully. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor or neighbor, don't be afraid of the bully. Do you hear me, poor child? Look at the text in verse 23. Goliath can be characterized as a bully. A bully is someone who uses superior strength or influence to intimidate someone else. Goliath was bullying Israel. He was taunting them. And I've discovered that bullies like to make a lot of noise. I've discovered that bullies like to talk a lot of trash. I've discovered that bullies like to be the center of attention. Bullies have a reputation. So not only do they make a lot of noise, bullies come with a reputation. Bullies enjoy invoking fear and talking trash. You know some bullies in your life, and you know that those bullies have a reputation of bullying. Do you mind if I call a few bullies? Cancer has a reputation. Diabetes has a reputation. Divorce has a reputation. Life has a reputation. Arthritis has a reputation. That's just to name a few. But all of these giants get up every day. They get up every morning. Sometimes when you wake up, they're standing over your Why, Pastor? Because the Psalter teaches the believer in Psalms 27 and 1, Sister Williams, the Lord is my light. I wish I had some help in here. And my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Beloved, we are as a body of believers. We need to learn how to speak in the Spirit through faith to those things which are trying to mow us down. Beloved, I believe that God is our light, because sometimes the enemy likes to attack in the dark. Sometimes the enemy knows if you see him, you won't be able to get away with it. So they come and try to creep up on you in the midnight hour while you're trying to rest and sleep. They try to get in your head. They try to make you not believe. The enemy comes in the nighttime. That's why I believe that the Psalter said, the Lord is my light. And I wonder, do I have any listeners who are ready to speak in the Spirit? Are you ready to speak in the Spirit through faith and tell the bullies in your life that you ain't scared? Why don't you look at your neighbor and say, I ain't scared? Why don't you shout it in the atmosphere? I ain't scared. Somebody came to church with a bully. You need to tell that prophet, I ain't scared. I'm not running from you anymore. I'm not conceding victory to you anymore. I'm not giving you my lunch money anymore. I'm not giving into your foolishness anymore. I'm not going to play these senseless games anymore, because God is my salvation. Do you hear what I'm saying, Sister Gladys? And I wonder, do I got anybody in here? You don't mind telling the truth that the Lord saved you. Not only did the Lord save your soul from the pit of hell, but God done saved some folk in here who were strung out on addiction. God done saved some folk out of here who had almost lost their mind. God has saved some folk in here from losing your career and losing your job. God saved some folk in here from losing your credit. God saved some folk in here, saved your life. Do I have anybody who knows God is my salvation? Not only does the text teach us not to be afraid of your bully, but look at it, Miss Gladys, the text is teaching us to realize you are being spooked over words and not action. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor or neighbor, why are you running? They haven't done anything yet. I wish I had some help. Realize, beloved, you're being spooked over words and not action. It's right there. It's right there. Red is right there in verse 24. It's right there, poor child, in verse 24. Darren is right there in verse 24. Brother Lamar is right there in verse 24. It says, all Israel, when they saw the man, they fled from him and were much afraid. Did you hear what I said, Brother Hubbard? It's right there in the text. The text says they looked, they saw, they ran. Did you hear what I said, Gladys? They looked, they saw, they ran. Did you hear what I said, Amica? They looked, they saw, they ran. Peacock, did you see that? They looked, they saw, they ran. Did you hear it? Did you see it? They looked, they saw, they ran. Dr. Houston, they looked, they saw, they ran. Mother Billingsley, they looked, they saw, and they ran. Did you hear what I said in the floor? They looked, Yes, that you're being spooked by words and not action. But now the text is teaching the believer that when you are on the battle lines and the bully is trying to bully you, you need to counter your fear with trust. Look at the text in 26.